Yeah. So it's my pleasure to introduce a speaker for this evening, Professor Sergey Karpovich Nemirovskii from Novosibirsk Institute of Thermophysics. He will tell us about recombination of vortex loops in health and theory of quantum turbulence. So please.
У меня такое ощущение, что могу спокойно говорить
по-русски. Нет, нет. Нет, нет, нет. У нас Дэвид Саммерс.
Well, I am starting. My talk will be very different from previous talk on this online conference. I had great doubts and shared my doubts with Professor Andrei Vesnin. Andrei in turn shared doubts with Professor Kaufman. Reaction of Professor Kaufman was about forward. I think that a good place to start would be material about recombination of vortex loops. This is very geometric and would be interest of everyone to in the seminar. If he is willing to give more than one talk, I would very much like to hear about quantum turbulence. Well, following Professor Kaufman's suggestion, I decided instead of separate talk to combine two talks today and present an extended introduction, which will essentially be a small review on quantum turbulence. It seems to me that this topic will be firstly interesting for audience, and secondly, will allow me to smoothly move on the main problem of the role of reconnection information of quantum turbulence. Well, I'll start with this movie. First observation of lambda transition is related to boiling of helium. You see, let me start. Well, this is intensive boiling of helium due to parasitic heat through walls of DR.
This rapidly evaporating liquid helium.
Well, the movie has their own sound. It's not very good. Let me tell about this. So now they decrease the temperature, and you see what happened. At some point, at this point, intensive boiling. Intensive bubble boiling disappears, and helium becomes very quiet and calm. Well, so, obviously that something happened with helium. I usually ask my student about helium, and I frequently, I usually got one or two correct answer. The point is that intensive boiling is impossible because of extremely heat conductivity of this new phase of helium. It prevents overheating, which is necessary to form vortex vapor bubbles. But why this new phase has a very intensive heat conductivity? This is very deep reason. Now I'll tell about two fluid model, which was elaborated mainly by Landau on the quantum mechanical consideration. On this base, the helium can be viewed as a mixture of two liquids. One of them is normal liquid with density rho n, which moving with velocity vn. It has shear viscosity, and it has entropy. But there is also superfluid component, which with density rho s moving with velocity vs, it has no shear viscosity, because of that it can't be involved into rotation, and it has no entropy. It cannot carry any heat. Well, such mixture can possess this unusual form of motion. If we, this is helium inside pipe, if we heat from one end, then the, it initiated this form of motion. The normal component flows from heater, carrying heat, and superfluid component flows in inverse direction, so the full total total flux is zero. This is very heat transfer is realized in fact in this mechanism. It's very intensive mechanism and very small heat flux, very small drop of temperature arises very large heat fluxes. This is correspond to this curve. But for some heat fluxes, this picture is violated and temperature drop rapidly increases. There is impression that there is something which prevents the free motion of normal component, which carries heat. This, what prevents is just tangle of quantized vortex filament. Vortex filaments which appear in superfluid component, they interact with normal component and prevent free motion of normal component. Well, a couple of words about vortex filament in helium too. It's idea, it was proposed by Feynman and Azager, and supposition was that this condition of rotational motion can be violated on the one-dimensional singularities. And about this one-dimensional singularities, they can be circle motion of superfluid component. And this very interesting fact, the circulation of superfluid velocity around these lines, is quantized. The quantum of circulation is Planck constant over a mass of helium. And it's so far it's first time when Max Planck constant appeared in macroscopical physics. Well, any line, it can be written as parameterized as a radius vector is a function of parameter xi and of course time t. Motion of this filament is very fancy. There is some part which corresponds to free motion of line. It is nothing but Biot-Savart law. You see that is nonlinear, singular, and non-local contribution is very difficult for theoretical. Besides of this, there are two additional terms which describe interaction with normal component. This, we will call it the friction term. Well, besides of this, let's say deterministic dynamics, yes, there is one more element of dynamics, that is the reconnection of vortex line. Being one-dimensional singularities during motion, they inevitably collide, and result of collision is reconnection when vortices flow change the topology. This two line change in this two line. In terms of vortex filament, this process is very sophisticated. Due to non-local Biot-Savart law, line moves at nearest segments reorientating and become anti-parallel. On this anti-parallel segments, cusps appear, and these cusps approach to each other, moving on the sides of pyramid. Distance between the tips of these cusps change on this law. Well, so I told about about dynamics of line, and let's come back to quantum turbulence. What is it for? There are several motivations to study this system. Let me demonstrate several slides about this. Interest in quantum turbulence is motivated by several things. First of all, it's a part of theory of superfluidity. It's closely connected with other problems like phase transition, dynamics of vortices, hydrodynamics, etc. One more extremely important line of interest currently being intensively discussed is the hope that the use of theory stochastic vortex line will help to clarify the perennial problem of classical turbulence, or at least to explain some key features like Kolmogorov spectrum, intermittency, etc. One more motivation is for theorists, attractive for theoreticians, is the theory of superfluid turbulence is an elegant and challenging statistical problem used for study of dynamics of chaotic set of string-like objects with nonlinear and non-local interaction. Plus interactions, plus reconnection, resulting in the fusion and splitting of vortex loop. I will tell about this later. Besides of great importance of superfluid turbulence in above mentioned case, I'd like to point out the theory of stochastic vortex tangle in quantum fluids is great interest importance from the point of view of general physics. This view is justified by existence of many physical fields of similar system of highly disordered sets of one-dimensional singularities. For instance, in this slide is depicted numerical calculation for evolution of cosmic strings, which probably exists somewhere in the universe after Big Bang. Well, another example is dislocation in solid, linear dislocation. They also can form some disordered state. Here is a tangle of string-like defect in pneumatic liquid crystal. Well, very interesting example. This is natural light fields and threaded by lines of darkness. They are called optical vortices that extend as lines throughout the volume of the field. One more example, this topological defect in Bose gas, but Bose gas is some nearest relative to helium 2. So this is a very similar theory, but you can see that the vortex filament are not extremely slim, but they rather are vortex tube. They have fine Participation of flow system. I will shortly tell about main trends and key results in theory of quantum turbulence. The first most outstanding in my side result was obtained in 50s is Feynman qualitative model and one in phenomenological theory. Sorry?
It was just noise, just some noise.
It's not question. It's question, not a question. To me or
not? No.
I didn't, okay. Feynman supposed that if there are some small vortex ring in helium under influence, they move to, so they increase their length, and total length increases. The vortex tangle becomes more and more dense. When vortex becomes very dense, the reconnection process comes into play. Due to reconnection, there is cascade-like reconnection of vortex line and change these loops into small vortex ring, which probably returns, so it's heat. So energy of kinetic energy transform into heat energy. Winding on the basis of this idea, Winding using experimental results, qualitative, dimensional, everything. He obtained developed a phenomenological theory. He obtained famous Winding equation, which is describe evolution of dynamics of vortex line density. Vortex line density, that is total length of vortex filament per unit volume. This term corresponds to growth of the line due to interaction with normal component. This is reflected by the fact that relative velocity between normal and superfluid component is here. And this second term corresponds to cascade-like break of vortex line. So in counterflow, vortex line density behave like this. In steady state, vortex line density is proportional to squared relative velocity. By the way, in spite of this formula exists about very many, about more than 50 years, there is no so far theoretical result on this formula. Another result is that mean curvature of the line is of order of interline space. This is interline space. L is one of over centimeter square. This is centimeter. This is exactly interline space. Well, previous results were obtained in 50s. There was some break. Mainly experimentalists studied flow in helium, and there are many experimental results, but understand what is happening, it's head break. At this time, there was result, I participated some activity, I participated in this, the interaction of quantum turbulence with nonlinear sound. Here is an example. This is classical Burgers triangle, nonlinear sound. Without turbulence, and due to turbulence, it's very deformed. It's it was very large activity. Well, the breakthrough happens in 18th. It was a numerical simulation by Schwarz. He obtained a result which confirmed ideas of Feynman that if we apply to the counterflow to some small vortex loops, we obtain developing vortex tangle, and this result of Schwarz is here. Well, in this time, it was a real sensation. Now, this results obtained by many people. I show results by obtained by Kandaurova about how is the development of vortex tangle. You can see that number of line increased, the tangle become more and more dense. And very interesting moment. You see that loops had different colors. After reconnection, when loop transformed in another loop, the colors of this line are changed. So the flickering of colors corresponds very many reconnection. So this very many reconnection. Okay. Well, that is about stationary state. Well, this results concerned numerical simulation. It was breakthrough. Now, numerical simulation is one main tool to study quantum torque. About main trends, currently it's quantum turbulence and studied in Bose and Einstein condensate. Excuse me, it's in Russia, it's occasionally. Bose, unlike in helium too, there is no microscopic theory, so dynamics of vortices is some phenomenological result. Unlike this, the helium Bose-Einstein condensate has something like microscopic theory. It says that dynamics of Bose condensate can be described in terms of macroscopic wave function. It's not real wave function which changes from atom to atom. It's some averaged macroscopic age. And this function obeys evolution of this function obeys to nonlinear Schrödinger equation or in context of Bose-Einstein condensate Gross-Pitayevsky equation. This is a complex function, of course, and being expressed in polar coordinate, it this rho is just density of condensate, and velocity is composed from the phase. It's a gradient of phase. It's why it's vortexless motion. Irrotational motion. Velocity is gradient of phase. Well, for this quantity, we can transform this very remarkable fact that evolution of rho and velocity It's almost Euler equation. The only there is some additional term which is called the quantum term. This is has some very unusual structure, and Planck constant appears this. So this is called Madelung transform. It was obtained in 20s. And Madelung thought that it's possible to describe quantum mechanics using this hydrodynamic representation. Well, very interesting moment how vortices looks like in Bose-Einstein condensate. If we take some points on the in two-dimensional situation, let's take that points where microscopic wave function vanishes, then expanding in Laurent series in vicinity of these points, we obtain the following expression, and in polar form we have this expression. That gradient of phase, this is for a phase of wave function. Gradient of phase has this expression. And this is nothing but a velocity field created by vortex line. And circulation about this point is quantized and is Planck constant over mass. In three-dimensional case, if we take a locus where both real part and imaginary part disappear, that this surface crossing of this surface, this line, and these lines are exactly vortex lines. Well, unlike helium 2, theory of Bose condensate shows how inside the core of the nuclear vortex line looks like. This is velocity field, this is density field. Very interesting result is illustration concerning reconnection in Bose condensate. You remember that if we consider vortex filaments, then reconnection process very fancy process, singular and very difficult for treatment. In Bose condensate, situation is about following. If real and imaginary part, this is plane, this is saddle point, and this plane moves, then and cross of this imaginary and real part of macroscopic function crossing is vortex line, then moving initiate process like this. This is a line approach to each other, this is the moment of collision, and then topology change and these two lines change into different lines. Well, one more result. now each is studying. Well, I'll tell about this. Several, about 20, there was some classical experiment. There is a result on measuring of spectrum of fluctuating liquid between two rotating blades. This is A and B is above lambda transition, so it corresponds to usual liquid. And point C is below T lambda. This is helium 2. And this is sensation because hydrodynamics is very different and vorticity. In fact, turbulence is dynamic of vorticity. And we saw the dynamics vorticity in helium two was rather different. It was concentrated in vortex filaments. Well, after that, there appears many works which try to study. Let me formulate. There are many works which try to study classical turbulence in terms of discrete lines. This activity was for a long time, and in book by Frisch there is even pictures by Leonardo da Vinci. This picture that observed turbulent flow in water and found that turbulence consists of many vortices. Well, so there is I demonstrated this picture, that turbulent picture, classical turbulence has filamentary structure. So probably solution to sacramental problem of classical turbulence, maybe it can be done studying quantized vortices. Well, let me tell about one more key results, about one more trend. This is technical application. There is a lot of technical applied work who study application of helium, turbulent helium too. For instance, turbulent helium 2 is used for cooling superconducting magnets in Large Hadron Collider. This is tube where particles are accelerated, and here is a superconducting magnet cooling by turbulent helium 2. One more example, turbulent helium 2 is used in cosmos for cooling electronic devices. Well, so I finished first part, which was some short review devoted to quantum turbulence, and now I will tell approach concerning this quantum turbulence. Well, we saw that dynamics of vortex line consists of two main ingredients. The first one, deterministic, is the motion of element of line due to equation, Biot-Savart law, mutual friction, etc. The second one is the random collision and reconnection and merging or self interaction and splitting of vortex loops. I depicted this here. This is the result of reconnection. Well, up to now, numerical result remains the main source information about dynamics of vortex tangles. The scarcity of analytical investigation is related to an incredible complexity of the problem. Indeed, we have to deal with set of objects which do not face a fixed number of elements. They can be born and die. The some analog of secondary quantization is required, with the difference that object vortex loops themselves possesses infinite number of degrees of freedom with very involved dynamics. Clearly, this problem can hardly be resolved in nearest future. Some approach crucially reducing the number of degree of freedom is required. Well, And now I will tell about role of reconnection. You see, well, the full rate of reconnection, number of events per 1 second per unit volume, is a function of vortex line density, and it obtained from numerical calculation. The rate of reconnection is about this. This is quantum of circulation. Let's take some typical experiment on superfluid turbulence with the counterflowing velocity of order 1 centimeter. Under this condition, the value of vortex line density is about 10 to 4 1 centimeter over centimeter squared. Then the full rate of reconnection is about 10 million collisions per second, or 1,000 collisions per each centimeter of line. Let's take, for instance, a loop of length of 10 interline space. This loop undergoes about 100 reconnections per 1 second, or in other words, it exists about 10 to minus 2 seconds without reconnection as a whole. After reconnection, it should change into other loops. The own vortex dynamics, Kelvin wave dynamics, is much more slow process. For instance, wave signal runs about loops in time about 10 seconds. Thus, the characteristic time of Kelvin wave dynamics is seed time exceeds time of existence of the loop by 1,000 times. I want to say by this argument that reconnection is more important process for dynamics of vortex tangle. The structure of any loop is determined by numerous previous reconnection. Therefore, any loop consists of small paths which remember a previous collision. These paths are uncorrelated since deterministic Kelvin wave do not have enough time to propagate far enough. Therefore, loop has a structure of random walk, like polymer chain. Main mathematical tool describe random walk is the Wiener distribution. Some generalized form here that probability to have any configuration is expressed by this integral, and this is something like Mexican hat like function. In for pure Wiener distribution is just a delta function. So according to this Wiener distribution, average loop can be imagined and consistent of many arches, which mean radius of curvature equal to xi zero, and these arches smoothly and randomly connected to each other. Quantity xi zero is important parameter of our approach. It plays of a role of elementary stop in theory of polymer. Being a Gaussian Wiener distribution allows to calculate any average functional dependent on vortex line configuration. Well, statement of problem. We concluded that all vortex loop has the same similar structure, and only difference is just length of loop. So we can introduce distribution function density of loop in space of their length. It's defined as number of loop per unit volume with length lying between L and L plus delta L. Knowing L in statistic of each loop, statistic of each loop is Wiener distribution, we are able to evaluate various property of real vortex tangle. Well, now about evolution of quantity n. There are two mechanisms. One of them is connected to deterministic motion. It's slow, not a main mechanism. But a second mechanism is related to random process of recombination. There are the two sort of recombination. This is fusion or merging of two loops. And another element due to self reconnection, a large loop can change into too small a loop. Well, what I said enough to write equation like kinetic Boltzmann equation for evolution of loop. This is called crossing term. In spite of, and each line here is depicted processes which are natural for this term. In spite of this cumbersome form, this kinetic equation it's quite transparent. Let's take, for instance, this term. It says, this sixth term, it says that number of loop on length L increases whenever the larger loop decay and one of dot loop is exactly L, loop with length L. Then we have to rate over all this lens and delta function control conservation of lens in process of reconnection. Well, I omit to slide about how to obtain this coefficient. This equation is has some bookkeeping character and physics of process is concentrated in this coefficient, but I omit how they obtained. It's very important that final expression are power likes coefficient A and B, power like coefficient which depend on length of loops entering to process, and there is velocity of approaching which is estimated as kappa quant circulation over radius of curvature, and some coefficients which depend on the temperature. It's I omit this calculation. This cumbersome equation has exact power-like solution. I mean a stationary case without deterministic term. This power-like solution has the following form, and it can be proved by using some special procedure, which is called Zakharov-Ansatz, who used this procedure for nonlinear for turbulence of nonlinear wave, that all terms in our kinetic equation after this transformation they can be grouped in this manner. And you see it's very interesting result that for parameter S equal to minus phi halves, for instance, here and here, this expression and this expression change into expression which is argument of delta function. So we have integral, collision integral has configuration like this and it's linear. Therefore, this is a solution of this kinetic equation. So we obtained resolved problem. We obtained distribution of line in space of the lens. So what is physical consequences of this? First of all, in fact, this distribution was sometimes discussed for various systems of one-dimensional singularities. However, it was only for thermodynamical equilibrium, and we have non-equilibrium state with some flux. flux, I mean flux of lengths in space of loop sizes. The term flux here means that the redistribution of lengths among the loops due to reconnection. If we multiply by L and integrate over L, we obtain vortex line density. Then we use it for kinetic equation, for balance equation, and we obtain for vortex line density expression like this. And this can be again with use of Zakharov abzats. It can be obtained that flux redistribution of line consists of two parts. One part positive corresponds to fusion of loops, and this second term corresponds splitting of loops. It's turbulence. Well, it's interesting. For low temperature, negative flux prevails. It's due to this coefficient depends on the temperature. For small temperature, cascade-like breakdown of loops prevail. So there is process of generation of smaller and smaller loops. There exists a number of mechanisms for disappearance of ring on very small scales. Well, therefore, we have some very steady turbulent picture with flux of energy or length in direction of very small loops. For larger temperature prevail fusion of loops, merging of loop, we obtain the larger and larger loop, and a large loop eventually results that we can very few lines stretching from wall to wall with very poor dynamics, so it's some generated state, no good turbulence. Well, there is one more physical interesting result. If we in stationary state when positive flux in the exactly compensate negative flux, we can obtain a constant C. And we obtain the vortex proportional to inverse squared radius of velocity of loop. I said that this result was obtained only numerically and analytically. I represent it here. This result says that structure of vortex tangles, that it consists about loops, the radius of curvature is of order interline space. This situation, straight line or this kinky line is impossible. Well, and this is probably last slide, rate of reconnection. The full rate of reconnection can be evaluated directly from master kinetic equation. Indeed, this equation describes change of vortex loop due to reconnection event. It takes into account site of event, depending on whether loop of size appears or dies in result of reconnection. Therefore, if we take all terms in collision integral with the plus sign, we obtain just the total number of reconnection. If we use for this Zakharov ansatz and our solution, we obtain the following result. Indeed, that number of reconnection is proportional to vortex line density with coefficient quantum circulation. And our calculation shows that this coefficient is about this quantity. It agrees with the numerical result. result, so but we obtain this result analytically. Well, it's about what I would like to say about role of reconnection in the structure of superfluid in quantum turbulence. I would like to do conclusion to second part. We demonstrated the dynamics of vortex tangle is satisfactorily described in language of kinetic of reconnecting, splitting and merging Brownian loops. The deterministic dynamic of vortex line is secondary in value. Well, the optimistic view is such that by varying of characteristic of Brownian loops, we are able to describe the full variety of phenomena of quantum turbulence. The pessimistic point is view that is impossible and the full solution of the problem requires something like string field theory for nonlinear string. It's impossible problem. And as Russian proverb says, a pessimist is a well-informed optimist. Well, that's all.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much for interesting talk. So please, questions.
Have you studied the reconnections of knotted vortices?
Sorry? Can you repeat? I didn't catch.
Vortices that are knotted. Have you studied vortices that are knotted? One-dimensional vortices whose topology is knotted.
Yes, of course, vortices are knotted, but I think reconnection violates this knotting or not. Previous reports, they are also important for understanding of quantum turbulence. I agree, especially this some properties of knotted. But it's some auxiliary instrument for studying evolution of quantum turbulence. It's my opinion.
Mm-hmm. Got a situation of a direct cascade, and in the direct cascade, the tangle went down to a bunch of small loops, and then the loops went away.
Well, when we have a direct cascade, when a prevail breakdown of loops, there are very small loops forms. And there are some reason, some physical grounds for disappearing of this loop. It can be acoustic radiation, because very small loops moves with very large velocity, comparable with sound velocity. There is also Kelvin wave cascade on this loop. Which also is ended with sizes of order of inter-atom, so it's changing to He. Because of that, there's direct the real turbulence when we have some sink for energy for small scales. In opposite case, there is not this mechanism, and only we can have lines stretching from wall to wall, so no cascade, some degenerated, with very poor dynamics for this configuration.
Thank you, Chris. More questions?
I have a question.
Yeah, please.
Sergey, thank you for nice presentation. My question is following. In some works, it was shown that Gross-Pitayevsky equation allows the generation of new loops between other vortex filament. Did you observe this phenomenon?
Let me obtain. You mean this picture, illustration for reconnection or what?
Not due reconnection. Additional generation of new loops in space between other vortex filament. Not.
But you see, it's not possible for topological reasons. The vortices have circulation, and if you mean bridging or what?
No. New closed vortex filament. Gross-Peterski equation.
Yes, I quote. This there is some numerical simulation which describes situation if we have two lines, and when they approach very closely, there possible generation of two very small loops.
Mm-hmm.
Well, yes, it's a very interesting result. I don't know whether it's possible for classical liquid. I don't know. It's
only for
probably you can replace this answer for classical liquid. It's possible. What do you think or not?
Only for quantum.
Only for quantum. But you see, what this equation this says that dynamics of Bose condensates it's fully equivalent Euler equation only with this additional term. Maybe because of this term, this is possible. I don't know. But it's some Madelung transform says that. Bose condensate equation is equivalent to Euler equation. Almost.
Okay, I will show you this works. Another question, can you repeat the role of Kelvin waves in quantum turbulence? Very small role?
Role of Kelvin waves, you see, this role is discussed due to how there is some decay of quantum turbulence, even for zero temperature, but there is no friction, no dissipation, usual dissipation. And there is a theory of Kelvin waves that on the loops, appear Kelvin waves. This is nonlinear waves, and there is possible, as for any nonlinear waves, there is possible direct cascade. They generate Kelvin waves with very small lengths. And this Kelvin wave should move very fastly and for instance, due to acoustical radiation. So the Kelvin wave in this manner describe loss of kinetic energy. So this is possible mechanism for decay of superfluid turbulence for very low temperature when there is no usual dissipation mechanism.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Please, more questions? I have a small question. You talked about low temperature case and high temperature case, but what means low, what means high?
Sorry?
You consider two cases, low temperature and high temperature.
Yes, but
what means low, what means high? So
low temperature is close to absolutely zero, but high temperature, of course, it's some ridiculous to say in helium too about high temperature. High temperature is In fact, this about 1.9, situation. The situation when this picture changed into this picture. Of course, it's not high temperature in usual case. It's temperature larger than some 1.9.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much for your patience.
Thank you.
Okay, are there more questions? If not, let us thank speaker again for the very interesting talk. And we put the slides on the homepage of the conference, and you can look at video and slides later. So thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you again.
So we'll see you next week.